Hey guys, welcome back. In the previous video, we completed this GUI part and now I want to search for a movie. So what I have to do, if I write any movie name here inside this entry field and click on the search button, I want to display a new window where you will be able to see all the details of this movie like this. So firstly, we will have to create a new window on top of the previous window and then we will be adding all these labels on it. Let's see. Now what I want, whenever I click on this search button, I want to call some function. So I'll pass a command here. So whenever you will click this search button, that command, that function will be executed. So I'm going to give a name search and let's define this at the top just after these import lines. So I'll give a comment here that this is the functionality part like this. And here this is the GUI part. Okay, so let's define this search function here, def search. Let me print here so that you guys are able to understand what this will do. So I'll print hello. So whenever you will be clicking on the search button, this hello text will be printed on the console. You can see whenever I'm clicking on this search button, hello is getting printed. So this function is getting called and the code that is written inside it is getting executed whenever you are clicking the search button. So what we want to create a new window on top of another window. For that, we have a class top level, which helps you to create a window on top of another window. And we have to create object of this top level class. So I'll give the object name as root one because root is the object of my original window. And this top level class has all the methods which are present inside this TK class. Right, this geometry, title, resizable, all are present inside this top level as well. Okay, so we have to keep our window on hold, so we'll be using root one dot main loop method. This will keep my window on loop. Let's see, if I click on the search button, you can see we are getting a window. So now let's increase the size, the width and the height of this window. Make sure you write everything between these two lines. So root one dot geometry method, this will help you to provide some width and the height to your window. So the width and the height is 890 cross 600 and from x axis I want to place my window at 200 distance and from y axis I want to place it at 50 distance. Let's see, if I click on the search button, you can see our window size is increased. The width is 890 and the height is 600. And the distance from the x-axis is 200, okay, and the distance from the y-axis is 50. So here you can see the by default title is of the original window. So let's change it to movie information. So root one dot title method, and here you have to mention the title in the form of a string. So I'm giving it a title of movie information. After that, I want to set the background color of this new top level window. So for that, I have one method config. This helps you to add background color to your window. Instead of config, you can also use configure method. Both work same. So I'll be using config here. And then I have to pass BG keyword argument. And here the value will be the color name. So whatever color you wish, you can use. I'll go with orange. Let's see. You can see the color of our window is changed to orange color. So after adding the background color, now we have to create all these labels. So for these labels, we will not provide any text initially. We will add the text when we will be fetching the data from database of IMDb server. Okay, so let's create a title label. So I'll give the object variable name as title label and I will be using a label class to create my label. And here I have to mention where I want this label. If you mention root, then this label will be on this window. But we want this label on this window. So we'll mention root one here. And then after that, if you want to add text to this label, you have to provide text keyword argument and the value will be title. After that, I want to provide some font to this text. So font keyword argument, and it has to be in the form of a tuple. The style that I'm going to use is Cooper Black. Then size is 30 and I'll make it bold. Now you will not be able to see this label until you place it. So I'm going to use title label object name dot place method. So here I have to mention x and the y coordinates where you want to position your title label. So I'll use x equals to 60 and y equals to 30. Let's see. You can see here we are getting this title label. Now I want to change the text color to white and the background color of this label to orange so that it matches with the background color of this window. So I'm going to use FG keyword argument for the text color and I'm going to give text white color. After that background color, I will change it to orange. Let's see. You can see the background color is changed to orange and the text color is changed to white. And now we will be creating another label on the right hand side where we will be displaying the title name. So I'm going to give object variable name as title name label. And I'll be using a label class to create a label. And this label again has to be on root one window. Let me add text for now so that you are able to see where this text is getting placed. So I'm giving text as hello. And after that, the font, I am going to use Algerian style. The size will be 20 and it will be bold. Now we have to place this title name label. So the height will be same as that of this title label, which is 30 here. Okay, only the X value will change for this title name label. So let's place it. Title name label dot place method. And the X will change to 300. And Y will remain same as 30. Let's run. You can see we are getting the label at this position here. So let's now change the background color and the text color. So the text color I will change it to white and the background will be same as that of our window, orange. So I'll copy background and the text color from here and I will paste it here. Control V. Let's see. Now you can see title and the text is written hello, right? But for now, we do not want to add any text on this label. We will be adding the text when we will be fetching the data from the database. So I will not give any text for now. So I'll remove it and let's see. Now you are not able to see anything because the text is not there on the label. In the same way, we have to create this director label and this director name label, but this label will not have text for now. Okay, so I will copy this label and will paste here and will change this object variable name from title label to director label and will also change the text from title to director. We also have to do changes in the X and the Y coordinates of this place method. I want to place this director label at the same distance of this title label from the X axis. So X value will remain same. The only change will be in the Y value. So I will change this Y value to 100. Let's see. Now you can see we are getting this director label. In the same way, we have to create director name label, but with no text. So I will be copying this title name label. We'll paste it here. If you want to place multiple cursors at a time, you have to press the Alt key and the mouse left button. So at a time, you will be able to change at two places. So director name label. Okay. And it will not have any text. In the place method, the X value will remain same because it has to be at the same position as this title name label from the X axis. The Y value will be changed because I want this director name label to be at the same height as this director label. So I'll change it to 100. Now we need to create year label. So I'll copy this director label, Control C, and I will paste it here and we'll change the variable to year label. And the text will also change to year. Again, the placement from the X axis will remain same. And the Y will change, so I'll change it to 170. You can see the difference is of 70 here. From 30, I change it to 100 and now to 170. If I run, you can see year label here. In the same way, we have to create year name label with no text. So I'll copy this director name label, control C, and we'll paste here. Now I'll change this director name label to year name label. The X value will remain same, the Y value will be changed to 170 so that it is at the same height as this year label. Okay. After that, we have to create runtime label. So I'll copy this year label and we'll paste here. So this year label will change to runtime. The text will also change from year to runtime. The X value will remain same. The Y will be changed to 240. Let's see. So we got this runtime label. Now we have to create runtime name label where we will be adding the runtime later on. So I'll copy this year name label and we'll paste it here. So year will change to runtime. The X value will be 300 and the Y will be changed to 240. Now we have to create general label. So I'll copy this runtime label and we'll paste here. We'll change the variable name from runtime to general label. And the text will also change to generates. X value will remain same. The Y will be changed to 310. Now we have to create general name label. So I'll copy this one without text and we'll paste here. So this one will be general name label. So I'm placing my mouse pointer at two position with the help of Alt key. And here it will be general name label. X value will remain same. The Y will be changed to 310. After that, we have to create rating label. So I'll copy this general label and we'll paste it here. We'll change the object variable name from general label to rating label. And the text will also change to ratings. The X value will remain same. The Y will be changed to 380. The same way, we have to create rating name label where we'll be displaying our rating. So I'll copy this and we'll paste here. So this will be rating name label. So I'm giving a similar name. It's up to you. You guys can use another name if you want. So the X value will remain same. The Y will be changed to 380. Now the last one, cast label. So I'll copy this and I will paste here. So rating label will be changed to cast label. Okay, text will change to cast. X value will remain same. The Y value will be changed to 450. In the same way, we want cast name label where we will be displaying all the names of the cast. So I'll copy this and we'll paste here. So rating name label will be changed to cast name label. Okay, X value will remain same, the Y will be changed to 450. Let's see. Search, and you can see we are getting all these labels over here. And the labels which are on the right hand side, there is no text, so we are not able to see them. And now we will see the logic of fetching the data from IMDb server so that we can display that data on these labels that we created on the right hand side. So see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.